Good day, STEM students. Welcome to our disaster readiness and our learning target according to our most essential learning competency. Fire brings about significant destruction to buildings, livelihoods, and most importantly, lives. Many fire incidents occur due to negligence and a lack of awareness about the various fire hazards present in our surroundings. To address this issue and raise awareness about the fire safety, the month of March is declared as the Fire Prevention Month in many countries, including the Philippines. During the Fire Prevention Month, the campaign for fire prevention is intensified through various activities and initiatives. The primary goal is to educate and inform the public about the importance of fire safety and the preventive measures that can be taken to reduce the dangers caused by fire incidents. The Fire Prevention Month serves as a reminder for individuals, households, businesses, and communities to prioritize fire safety and take proactive steps to prevent fires from occurring. Let's begin the discussion about fire hazards by having activity number one. In this activity, it is simple, entitled as Theme Park on Fire. So simply, I have here a news clip that I want you to watch and analyze. This talks about the Star City fire incident. Now, after watching the video, I want you to answer the questions that follow. Here is the video.
Apat na araw matapos masunog, ipinakita sa media ang loob ng Star City. Inikot ang ilang bahagi ng theme park para matukoy ang posibleng pinagmulan ng sunog. Tulad ng lokasyon ng bumper boats kung saan may nakitang gasolina sa tubig nito.
Yung gasolina nandoon sa bangka-bangka, inaalon lang siya. Wala siyang makina. Nakitaan natin ng gasolina, gusto sabihin, hindi siya dapat andoon.
Base sa mga sample na nakuha, arson ang nakikita ng City Fire Marshal na dahilan ng pagkasunog ng halos buong compound ng Star City. Ilang oras bago magkasunog, may isang tenant at ilang empleyado ang nakapagpasok umano ng sako-sakong bulak sa loob ng amusement park at hindi sila nag-log in. Dahil dito, ipatatawag ang mga may-ari ng Star City para ipakita ang kanilang financial statements.
Naglogbook siya, hindi niya nilogbook ang mga kasama niya.
Are you implying na may-ari yung gumawa?
Oo, siyempre, ganun yon. Kasi they have the full control of the area. Pag arson, it's either ibang tao, kasi may tenant nga, yon, titingnan natin.
Pero ayon sa tagapagsalita ng Star City, may motor ang mga bangka sa bumper boats kaya may gasolina raw ito. Hindi rin daw pwedeng magpatay ng kuryente sa may snow world dahil sa niyebe. Wala rin umanong mali sa pagpasok ng bulak sa compound dahil ginagamit ito sa mga stuffed toy.
Walang motive because Star City is making money. We expect to make more money, much more money in this season. Christmas season eh. Now, what will we do?
Handa rin humarap ang pamunuan ng Star City sa City Fire Marshal kung ipapatawag sila. Jackie Manabat, ABS-CBN News.
Here are the guide questions. I want you to read it, analyze it, and answer it on your own. You may replay the video or the news report for you to be able to understand and recall and answer the following questions. I'm giving you 30 seconds to do it. Okay, and now let's answer these guide questions. So first question, enumerate the possible reasons that could have caused the fire. There are several possible reasons that could have caused the fire at Star City. So according to the news report, first, arson. Initially, investigations suggested that the fire was caused by arson, with traces of gasoline detected in the remains of the building. The second possible reason, electrical malfunction. It was later confirmed that the fire originated from an electrical fire that started in a game booth located on Star City's ground floor. Another possible reason, equipment malfunction. There is a possibility that a malfunction in equipment or machinery within the amusement park could have sparked the fire. And possible reason also is a human error. It is also possible that human error such as negligence or improper handling of equipment or flammable materials could have contributed to the fire. Next question. If you were part of the management team, what could have been done to prevent the accident? Now, you may agree or you may not agree, but if we were part of the management team or I were part of the management team, here are some measures that could have been taken to prevent the accident. So first, regular maintenance and inspection. Implementing a strict maintenance and inspection schedule for all electrical systems, equipment, and machinery within the amusement park to identify and address any potential issues or malfunctions before they become a fire hazard. Fire safety training and protocols. Ensuring that all staff members receive proper fire safety training and are aware of the necessary protocols to prevent and respond to fire incidents effectively. A next suggestion, if I were part of the management team, adequate fire suppression systems, meaning installing and maintaining appropriate fire suppression systems such as sprinklers and fire extinguishers throughout the premises to quickly contain and extinguish fires, and also clear evacuation plans. Developing and regularly practicing evacuation plans to ensure that visitors and staff can safely exit the premises in the event of fire. Strict control of flammable materials, enforcing strict control and storage procedures for flammable materials used within the amusement park to minimize the risk of accidental fires, and also having collaboration with fire authorities. Establishing a strong partnership with local authorities to conduct regular inspections, receive guidance on fire safety measures, and stay updated on any regulations or recommendations. These are just some of the preventive measures that we can do enable for us to prevent fire hazards. Now, the Star City fire incident is just one of the incidents that the Philippines experienced for the past year. Now, let's talk about fire. When we say fire, it is described as the rapid oxidation of a material in the exothermic chemical process of combustion. Releases heat, light, and various reaction products. The natural phenomena, when harnessed correctly, has been pivotal in human advancement, aiding in cooking, heating, and driving industrial progress. However, fire's impact extends beyond human use. It plays a crucial role in the environment. Natural fires, particularly those of low intensity, can be beneficial to ecosystems. They help maintain ecological balance by removing dead or decaying matter, which in turn reduces competition for nutrients among plant species. Additionally, these fires can eliminate pests and diseases affecting certain plants and trees, promoting healthier and more diverse ecosystems. In some environments, fire is essential for the regeneration of certain plant species, as the heat from the fire can trigger the germination of seeds. This natural cycle of fire and regrowth ensures the sustainability and vitality of many ecosystems. Now, there are elements of fire and stages of fire development. Now, let's elaborate them one by one. Fire is a chemical reaction that occurs when three elements come together, known as the fire triangle. So we have the fuel, heat, and oxygen. Understanding these elements is crucial comprehending how a fire starts and sustains itself. So let's talk about fuel. Now, when we talk about fuel, this simply refers to any material that can burn and provide the necessary energy for a fire. This can include substances such as wood, paper, fabric, gasoline, or natural gas. When fuel is exposed to heat, it can reach its ignition temperature, the point at which it starts to burn. Now, the second element is the heat. Heat is the energy required to raise the temperature of the fuel to its ignition point. Now, it can from various sources such as open flames, electrical sparks, hot surfaces, or chemical reactions. Once the fuel reaches its ignition temperature, the heat further accelerates the chemical reaction, releasing more energy in the form of heat and light. And the last element is oxygen. As we all know, oxygen, it is very vital for the survival of the organism. But aside from that, oxygen is essential for combustion to occur. It reacts with the fuel, allowing it to burn and sustain the fire. Air contains about 21% oxygen, which is usually sufficient for most fires. However, in some cases, additional sources of oxygen, such as pure oxygen or oxidizers, can intensify a fire. Once these three elements come together, a fire can start and continue to burn. Removing any one of these three elements can extinguish the fire. For example, let's remove the fuel. If the fuel source is removed or consumed, the fire will no longer have anything to burn and will go out. Now, let's say we remove the heat. So when we remove the heat, the temperature goes down. So there's cooling. Cooling the fire by applying water or using a fire extinguisher can reduce the temperature below the ignition point, depriving the fire of the necessary heat to sustain itself. Therefore, there will not be fire. Let's say we remove the third element, which is the oxygen. Now, smothering the fire by covering it with a fire blanket or using a fire extinguisher that displaces oxygen can starve the fire of oxygen, causing it to extinguish. Meaning, in simpler words, for us to come up with a fire, there must be three elements present: oxygen, heat, and fuel. Now, let's talk about four stages of the fire development. So as you may see in this graph, we have four stages, namely incipient, growth, fully developed, and decay. Now, let's elaborate them one by one. Now, fire development can be divided into four stages, now each categorized by specific characteristics and behaviors. These stages are known as fire development or fire growth stages. So let's talk about the first stage, which is incipient stage. When we say incipient stage, it is the initial phase of a fire. Now, it begins with the ignition of the fuel and lasts until fire starts to grow and spread. At this stage, the fire is typically small and localized. With a limited fuel supply, it produces minimal smoke and heat. And the flames may not be visible yet. This is the stage to extinguish a fire quickly and safely using a fire extinguisher or other appropriate means. So if we want to remove quickly the fire, this is the right stage for us to do it. Next, let's say incipient stage is already done. Now, the next stage will be the growth stage. Now, in this stage, the growth stage is when the fire starts to grow rapidly, okay, and spread to adjacent fuels. Now, the fire generates more heat, more smoke, and flames become more visible. The fire intensity increases, and it may start to produce dangerous levels of toxic gases. So this stage can be dangerous as the fire can rapidly escalate and pose significant risks to occupants and the property. It is crucial to evacuate and contact emergency services at this stage. Okay? Now, the third stage is the fully developed stage. Now, the fully developed stage is when the fire reaches its maximum growth and intensity, meaning the fire consumes all the available fuels within the reach. Now, without fuels, the fire cannot grow more. Now, generating intense heat, thick smoke, and large flames, the environment becomes extremely hazardous, making it difficult for the occupants to escape without proper protection. So in this case, if we evacuate, we need extra protection. Okay. At this stage, firefighting efforts focus on controlling the fire's spread and protecting surrounding structures. Now, the last stage is the decay stage, from the word itself, decay. So there is a dying element. So the decay stage is the final stage of the fire development. It occurs when the available fuels is depleted and the fire starts to diminish its size and intensity. However, hot embers and pockets of heat may still extinguish and any remaining hot spots and ensure the area is safe before considering the fire fully extinguished. Now, after elaborating the three elements of fire and also the different stages of fire development, now let's talk about and discuss the causes of fire. So there are several causes of fire that somehow we able to be complacent and hindi natin napapansin na yun na talaga yung pwedeng mag-trigger ng fire that may lead to a disastrous event. So for example, we have the cause number one, the faulty electrical wiring or connection, or also known as the octopus wiring, especially in our weather condition today. We are experiencing hot or high temperature, therefore the appliances rapidly heating, some of them experiencing overheat that may lead to a fire. Next, the LPG related incident. So here sometimes or most of the times it is caused by the negligence of the people. Okay, so here we did not take good care of the LPG tank. Its location, yung proper storage niya, that's why it might trigger a fire. Next, we have the lighted cigarette pads. Okay, so ito yung mga upos ng sigarilyo na itinatapon na lang sa paligid natin. There are cases na pwede silang matabi or mailagay sa mga light materials that may lead to ignition, to fire. And kapag masyadong marami around the area yung mga lighted materials, there is a possibility na mag-spread siya rapidly. Okay, so also the left unattended open flame. candle or gasera. So ito nangyayari to especially kapag nagkakaroon ng blackout or brownout. So there are possibilities na naglalight tayo ng candles and naiiwan siyang unattended. So if that's the case, there is a possibility that it might have an interaction with the light materials that may lead to ignition and cause fire. Also, the unchecked electrical types of machinery. Okay, so we must be able to be aware of all the machineries that we use in our daily activities. So, kapag meron nga tinatawag tayo yung mga voltage na 110 and 220, so there is a proper usage of them. Okay? Flammable chemicals. Here, there are materials, cleaning materials at home that we should put into proper storage because there are materials that must not be exposed in a temperature, let's say 30 degrees Celsius and above, because when they are exposed higher to the given temperature, they might trigger an ignition or fire. Okay, incendiary device or ignited flammable liquid. So, commonly, New Year, may mga ganitong cases tayo na they use this to simply make an explosion, to make some noise. But mishandling of this might trigger a fire. Okay, also the underplant pyrotechnics. So here we must use the pyrotechnics in an open area away from any flammable materials that may trigger fire. Next, bomb explosion. Okay, so here we usually see this during wars. The main goal of this is to put destruction to the structure, infrastructure, or buildings. And of course, lightning. Since lightning, it triggers some spark, so it when it become interacted or make an interaction with some materials, it might trigger fire. Now, flammable materials could also ignite on their own in an event referred to as spontaneous combustion. Nagiging challenge nga ngayon is social media, hindi ba? Yung pagkakaroon natin ay yung pagluto ng itlog gamit lang ang sikat or init na mula sa sikat ng araw. So, there are lightweight materials, especially, let's say, in an open area na mapuno. So, mayroon mga dried leaves na naglalaglagan. So, there is a possibility when there is too much high temperature within the area due to the weather or the climate condition, it might trigger some ignition. Okay, so that is referred to as spontaneous combustion. Meaning, this is a fire caused by natural process. Okay, now let's talk about the precautionary and safety measures. Okay, what are the things or preventive measures that we may do at home to prevent these fire hazards? So first, never leave a fire unattended. So especially when we have backyards, open area. Now when we clean, iniipon yung mga kalat, the dried leaves, and also the trashes sometimes, na pinagbabawal lang ngayon pagsusunog ng mga basura, there is a possibility na magsiga sa labas, and then afterwards, iniiwan na lang yung pinagsunugan. And the reason is, smoke na lang naman. Again, when there is a smoke, there's a fire. Okay? So, never leave a fire unattended. Now, always check the electrical equipment, especially if there is a sign of some electrical short circuit. Meaning, let's say, at home, bigla tayo nagkaka-experience ng mga pag-corrupt ng ating mga supply ng kuryente. Biglang namamatay, sindi. There is a possibility na yung ating electrical wiring is disturbed or hindi na maayos. So, we must check it all the time. Okay, keep a good distance between things that can catch fire. So again, the materials inside the kitchen must not be near enough doon sa ating mga fire stoves, electric stoves, or kung anumang stoves na pwedeng makakapit agad ng fire that might cause a flame. Kasi kapag ganun yung nangyari, there is a possibility na pwedeng kumalat agad yon sa bahay. So again, use caution with electricity. So make sure na yung mga saksakan natin sa bahay, nakikita lang natin just to make sure na kung sakaling magkaroon man ng abirya, mag-short circuit or mag-smoke man, madali nating malalapitan. And monitor space heaters with proper ventilation, of course. And again, as I always mention, education, awareness. Educate children and adults about the fire safety. And the store flammable materials properly, as mentioned earlier, there are materials at home that we use that might cause fire or flame quickly. So there must be a proper storage for them. And keep a fire extinguisher of a bucket or a bucket of sand handy, meaning kailangan natin mayroong fire extinguisher at home. Okay, as our prevention measure. So the purpose of bucket of sand, so para at least maapulan natin agad yung apoy to prevent the fire in the presence of oxygen. So again, the goal is to eliminate the oxygen source so that we could extinguish fire quickly. Of course, install fire alarms and smoke detectors, especially sa mga public areas, sa mga buildings, ganyan na maraming tao, condominiums, schools. Yan, dapat meron tayong mga fire alarms and smoke detectors. And know what to do in case of the fire. So here, we have different practices and evacuation measures depending on the kind of hazard we want to address. So for example, during earthquake, duck, cover, and hold. Now here in the fire, so there is a possibility, let's say, na meron tayong madikitan na merong apoy, and then mag-apoy yung kasuotan natin. So the goal is to apula agad yung apoy. So we may use wet cloth or mag-drop tayo and roll. Okay, so here, stop, drop, and roll. If in earthquake, we have the cover and hold on, so here we have naman stop, drop, and roll technique. And of course, develop a fire preparedness plan. So here, in every area of the building, kailangan visible and magiging aware, accessible for all the occupants of the area for them to be aware where to go in case of fire emergency. Okay? So here, the key for preventing fires from occurring is to make sure that elements of fire triangle do not come together. Again, as mentioned, a fire cannot be possible if there is one missing element. There must be three elements present. So to extinguish the fire, the goal is to remove at least one element. Okay, and prevent ignition by making sure that flammable materials do not heat up and reach the ignition temperature. So with this, we should make that the ignition sources should be kept away from the fire. And in case of breakouts, smoother to eliminate is the source of oxygen. That's why we use a wet cloth and a bucket of sand. That's all for now. Once again, thank you for listening. And don't forget to accomplish all the tasks related to our lesson today. If you don't have any more question, concern, if you have one, don't hesitate to message me and I will try my best to reply quickly. Now, I hope you learned something new in this video lesson. Keep safe. God bless. Take care, everyone.